welcome in online series of machine design. Myself Namisha Goswami. So in this lecture we will discuss about different type of materials which are used to manufacturing of wearing, and we will design one wearing by using one numerical example, right? So in this lesson or in this lecture we will cover general wearing, wearing materials and one numerical example. So what is general wearing? So general wearing are comes under sliding contact wearing. Okay, so that portion of the shaft which is inside of wearing is known as your general. So this is sliding contact bearing having high coefficient of static friction, and these are having these have some surface area, okay, and contact of surface between two elements may be surface contact, right? So this is your general bearing. Next is your bearing materials. So bearing is generally made of your chrome steel. Okay, so this is your most common material which is used to produce load carrying component in precision ball bearing. Okay, so you can see here I have specified this is used in precision ball bearing, roller bearing and top taper roller bearing. So chrome, what is the chrome is used? Chrome steel is used. So that is used 52100 chrome steel. Chrome steel. Okay, so this is the one particular type of your chrome steel. Okay, so these components are the bearing of the inner and outer rings, balls and bearing. So chrome steel is used to manufacturing of your component, different component. For example, your outer ring, your inner ring, for you to manufacturing of balls, to manufacturing of your rollers. So we use chrome steel. Okay, and next is used Babbitt bearing. So what is Babbitt bearing made of? Okay, so Babbitt bearings are generally Babbitt bearing. Okay, so general bearing we have discussed already. Okay, so bearing, Babbitt bearings are used for or made of general bearing. Okay, so general bearing are plain bearing which are consist of a shaft or general which rotate freely inside of supporting metal. Okay, and sleeve or shell. Okay, so there is no rolling element in these type of bearings are used. So these type of bearings are typically lubricated, and we have to apply some lubrication in this type of the bearing. Okay, so lubrication may be grease or to add in the supporting of the load. Okay, so grease may be used and some other lubricant may be used for the support. So they will act like to supporting the load. Okay, so Babbitt bearings are sleeve bearings made of certain types of alloys and which are melted down and cast to produce the bearing surface. Okay, so mainly casting process or casting manufacturing process is used to manufacturing the bearing surface. Next is your, the Babbitt bearing was invented in 1839 by American scientist known as Isaac Babbitt. And okay, so first type of Babbitt plain bearings are combined or composed of, or you can say that this is the alloy of tin, antimony and copper. Okay, so Babbitt is made of tin, antimony and copper. What metals are ball bearing made of? Okay, so Babbitt bearing are sleeve bearing made of certain types of alloys. Okay, so again here process is explained. So this is used, or casting process is used to produce or to manufacturing of your bearing surface, right? Now, so most of the ball bearings are made of some steel, and these are known as some with the alloy of the high carbon chromium steel. Okay, and these are also known as chrome steel. Okay, so Babbitt is the soft or non-ferrous alloy which is used to produce the bearing surface. Now, bearing are also used in engines to support moving mechanical parts and protect them from frictional degradation. Means these are used as a supporting member. Okay, and these also have, Babbitt also have the properties to reduce the friction, which is made in good material for use in plain bearing. So these are, Babbitt are basically used to reduce the friction in plain bearing. Okay, so now come to the, we will design one bearing by using one numerical example. So here 150 mm diameter. So before doing the design procedure, this is important, understood each and every term of given in your numerical problem. Okay, so first of all, 150 mm diameter shaft supporting a load of 10 kN has a speed of 1500 rpm, means shaft diameter is equal to 150 mm. Load W is given 10 kN and RPM is given 1500 RPM. Okay, the shaft runs in bearing whose length is 1.2 times the shaft diameter. So what is the length of bearing? Length of bearing is L, small L. So a small L is given 1.5 times of your D, right? If the diametral clearance of the bearing is 0.15, so what is the diametral clearance is given? C. So C is equal to 0.15 mm. Okay, and absolute viscosity of the oil at the operating temperature is given 0.011 kg per meter second. And find the power wasted in friction. Okay, so here you can see here diameter clearance is given. Okay, and your viscosity is given. You have to find out power wasted in friction. Okay, so indirectly they have asked find out your heat generation due to friction. Okay, whatever amount of power will be generated inside of bearing, so that power may be wasted, right? So indirectly they have ask you to find out heat generation inside of your bearing. So first of all, first step should be write down your given data. So D is equal to 150 mm. Load W is equal to 10 kN. So this is equal to 10,000 newtons. N is equal to 1500 RPM. Okay. Small L is equal to 1.5 D. C is equal to 0.15 mm. It is also given, right? And Z viscosity is given 0.011 kg per meter second. So now what should be the first step? Okay, so first step, there is relation between L and D is given. So first of all, we have to find out length of bearing. Okay, so L is equal to 1.5 times of D. So this was your first step. So L is equal to 1.5 of D. So put the value of D. Okay, so D is given 150 mm, diameter of journal is given. So this is equal to 150 mm. So L is equal to 1.5 multiplied by 150. So this is equal to 225 mm. So this is equal to length of your journal bearing. Next step should be we have load, right? Load is given. You can see here. W is given. L we have find out. D is given. So what should be our next step? Our next step should be bearing pressure. Okay, so bearing pressure is equal to load divided by L into D. So W is given, it is equal to 10,000. L we have find out 220 mm multiplied by diameter. So this is equal to 115 mm. Okay, so P is equal to what should be the bearing pressure we have obtained. So bearing pressure obtained by this is equal to 0.296 newton per mm square. Now what should be the next step? So next step is coefficient of friction. Okay, so how this is the standard value, I have already explained it in previous lectures, or you can take directly from your design data book. So in this case, in this coefficient of friction, you can see here Z is already given, N is given, P we have find out, D and C is also given, and K is your N leakage factor. So its value is equal to 0.002. okay, so just put the all value 33 divided by 10 to the power 8 multiplied by Z is equal to 0.011 multiplied by pressure, sorry, RPM. RPM is given 1500. Okay, divided by bearing pressure, we have obtained 0.296 newton per mm square, and multiplied by D by C. So D is your 150. Clearance, diameter clearance is given 0.1. Okay, and so 0.15, right, plus K. Okay, so by using this relation, I will put this value of K. So you will get your coefficient friction. So coefficient friction is equal to 0.02. Next is your rubbing velocity. So velocity is equal to pi d n by 60. So just put the all value. Pi we know 3.14. D is given 0.15 meter, and n is given 1500 divided by 60. So we will get velocity is equal to 11.78 meter per second. Okay, now so what is the heat generation due to friction? So heat is given by mu W into V. So QC is equal to mu W V. Mu we have already calculated, W already given, we have calculated here 11.78. So put the all values in this equation. So I have put it here, all value you can see here. So we will get QC is equal to 0.2 multiplied by 10,000 multiplied by 11.78. Okay, so mu is equal to 0.02 and W is equal to 10,000 Newton and V is equal to 11.78 meter per second. So we will get QC in watt, 2356 watt. So whatever amount of heat generation, so that should that will be wasted in that power will be wasted due to friction. So power wasted in friction should be equal to QG, and this is equal to 2356 watt. Okay, so it was asked in your numerical problem. Thank you. Keep watching.